Hello students, today's topic is computer and its component. The content of today's topics: concept of computer, term related to computer, benefit of using computer and working model of computer. Now let's start with the first topic, concept of computer. First we have to know that what is computer. A computer is an electronic device which help us to store and process the data. Now, let us understand an example of computer. Say we want to store a photograph in our machine. For that, we need computer. Say we want to multiply two big number, which can be a fault if we do it by our own. So, by using computer, we can do this task very easily. Now, next, term related to computer. There are few terms which are related to computer, like what we can see: data, instruction, information, processor, hardware, software and network. Let us explain each term separately. First, data. What is data? Data is raw fact, like a photo, a video or a image. Anything can be a data. Next, instruction. Instruction is the information given to the computer to perform a task. Next is information. Now we have data, we have instruction. We will apply the instruction on the data to get the information. That means information is actually the processed data. Next is processor. Processor, the task of the processor used to perform the instruction on the data. Next is hardware. The mechanical or electrical device which are connected with our computer are called hardware, like our monitor, our mouse, our printer, our scanner, whatever. These all are the hardware devices. Now, software. Software is a set of instructions which help the computer to perform our task very quickly. Next is network. The purpose of network is to connect more than one computer together. Say five computers are connected together, so it is our network. By using that network, that five computer can share their information among each other. Next is benefit of using computer. There are few benefits of using computer. First is, we can say that speed up. Like as we have taken the example of multiplying to big number, if we do it by our own, there is a huge chance that it will take much time. But if we use it our computer, then it will take a minute only. Then next is reliability. Same example we can consider, that by using computer it will not do any mistake, but if we do it by our own, it may possible that there is few mistakes in multiplication. Storage. The computer provides us the capacity to store data in the machine. Next is versatility. What we can say, that while doing a task, say we are making a PPT, at the background we can view a photograph, or say listen to the music by using YouTube. That more than one task we can do simultaneously in computer is called the versatility of the computer. Next is working model of computer. Say what we can see here, the main four component of the computer is input device, processing unit, output device and storage unit. So what we can see, our computer takes the input from the user. Then after taking the input, what it will send it to the processor, that our CPU. Then processor will do the instructions based on whatever user has given. Then after, processor will make the output and send the output to the output device, like to the screen. By the time, processor will store the data to the storage device, which can be a pen drive, which can be our main memory, which can be a CD drive, anything. Let us give some example of each of the unit. First, for input device, the example of input device can be a keyboard. It can be a mouse, it can be a scanner, anything is can be a input device. Processor. CPU, central processing unit, is the processor of our computer. It performs the task. Next, the output device, the computer screen is the output device of our computer. Next is storage device. Storage device, as we have discussed already, that pin drive, memory chip, CD drive, our hard disk, main memory, all are the storage device only. Let's play our quiz. Now, the question is, monitor is a dash device. The example we have just discussed, it can be an input device, it can be an output device, it can be a processing unit as well. So let's think about the picture, whatever is given here. Now you decide what is the purpose of this device. Is it take the input from the user? Is it give the output to the user? Or it is we use for processing? Now we have given you enough time. Now let me discuss the result with you. Monitor is a output device. As we have discussed, the purpose of the monitor is to print the output to the user. One more question we will discuss, that computer is not versatile. Just think about what is the task of a computer. Think about the picture given here and answer whether it is true or whether it is false. As we have discussed, that while doing a work, it can do another work. Can you think that whether it is versatile or not? I think you have answered correctly, and yes, it is false. Thank you. The next session of this chapter, we will discuss on the next video. Thank you for listening.